What's the score?
When troubled meets the troubadour.
Seen stolen through the outside door. Please tell me, what's the score?
When troubled meets the troubadour.
I've been down upon the barroom floor. Please tell me, what's the score?
When troubled meets the
so much more. Please tell me, what's the score?
When trouble meets the troubadour.
Who wins? Who dares? Who cares? Just tell me, what's the score?
When trouble meets the troubadour.
Landlord, what's the score?
When trouble meets the troubadour.
Somebody, please tell me, what's the score?
When trouble meets the troubadour.
Come on, what's the score?
When trouble meets the troubadour.
So what's the score?
When trouble meets the troubadour.
This is the sorry tale of when men were not sure about how to be a man. And when their asses weren't sure about where their elbows were either. A time when traditional roles had been replaced by modern technologies and outlets for men to express themselves left the sports field, barroom fueled banter, or dressing up in a fluorescent green mankini with obligatory bowler hat to give it large whilst parading through the beautiful and highly cultural streets of the city of Prague. Here, we meet two outsiders to all this. Dejected Dom, down on his luck and becoming increasingly more cynical as a result, as his thoughts grow dark and begin to cloud his troubled mind as he searches for a way out. And then there's the hapless troubadour, Sam, a quixotic figure, still hopelessly finding his way in this world, taking the slings and arrows life throws as he so valiantly tries to be accepted by it. Now tonight they are to meet unexpectedly for the first and they discover they share more in common than initial impressions would suggest. With the overseeing help of their friendly neighbourhood landlord, Gentleman's Jim, they are then able to move forward together to see a new way. So, ladies and gentlemen, please sit back, relax, and enjoy as this heartwarming story unfolds. And men, please, on this, your international evening, please feel free at any point during this evening's performance, should you so wish, to stick your hands down the front of your boxes and give your balls a good scratching. And while you're at it, don't forget to test your testicles. Let the play commence.
Money in my pocket, but I just can't get no love. Ain't that a shame?
Thank you. Oh, such heartache. Indeed, I know what it is to have loved and lost, to have experienced the tormented sadness of not being able to express one's innermost feelings. Why is this so for us, I wonder? Oh, and what is the cure? Fine evening.
Whatever.
Ooh,
why, thank you, kind sir. You indeed. Such a kind gentleman to offer a complete stranger hospitality or delectable drinking deck.
Free country.
That is indeed so. But what a kind and noble deed it was to offer a complete stranger a need of hospitality and rest and sustenance upon travelling so far and wide and sea and many a
far. Alright, so how far and bleeding wide have you travelled for this evening to be here on this deepest, dark blue cross on this cold evening?
Why? Charlton, my good sir!
Charlton, yeah. Are you having a laugh? That's only 20 minutes away on the 53 bus if you're lucky.
Ah, yes, but what a lot can happen on that bus in those 20 minutes.
What, did someone ask to see your ticket?
No, for that surely would have been in most America. Oyster. Yeah, you got it? Oh, the contactless. Yeah, there we go. See, sir?
So, did someone ask to see if they could sit next to you?
No, I always end up sitting on my own.
You mean there was no one else on the bus?
Well, there was when I first got on, but thereafter, nobody.
So you mean when travelling so far and bleeding wide, you always end up on your own?
Yes, although I do converse with many from so far and wide, and travel on many buses, I often end up travelling on my own.
I think I'm beginning to see why. So what makes you still so bleeding chirpy then? What you want?
Why? Life, my good sir, and not so bit. I have travelled far and wide and seen many a wondrous sight to be here this fine evening, in Charlton.
Yeah, on an empty 53 bus.
Well, no. Exactly. Let me see if I can explain. I thought I'd be walking to the front of the stage, but yeah. Right. This is a song about an emotional boy, which I am, if you haven't noticed. Here we go. Oh, and the chorus goes, "Nobody likes an emotional boy." See if you can sing along. Nobody likes an emotional boy. 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 I've traveled far and wide.
Give my heart and soul to your sister. Yeah.
very well and good, but can't you see that people are just, well, laughing?
Why, for that is the greatest reward for all my endeavours. That, and a little smile away from those pretty young ladies down the street. Because, I know this one again. Man, I feel like a woman. Let's go, girls.
Oh, you mean those very nice young ladies who only appear to come out at night and seem to be wearing oh so very little for a cold night out in South East London.
Oh, you know of whom I speak. Yes, when that happens, my life is almost complete.
What century are you from? Can't you see their heads smiling with you? They're laughing at you.
Pray not.
I'm sorry, buddy, but I believe it's true. They're either just having you on or after your money.
No, sir, if you indeed have it wrong. I bring a smile to their face with the spreading of joy, merriment and song. On my travels, both far and wide, I have opened doors for many people. I have laid my coat over puddles, you can tell, for fair maids to cross. I have rescued damsels in distress from towers, and I've shared my last shekel with newfound friends.
And did they all smile and say, why thank you, kind sir?
No, not exactly.
And where are they all now?
Well, there's Tom, and Tom was a great, such a great guy, and we had such an adventure, and then he left. Yeah, okay, but there's Sally. Oh, Sally, whoa, Sally, she was amazing. But then she left to find Tom.
Well, my friend, that seems very chivalrous and commendable of you. But I'm afraid not everyone's the same as you, and they see your kindness as a world weakness. I would just take advantage, if you let them.
No, sir, you indeed have it wrong. I've travelled far and wide. See, these guys know where I've been. I have travelled far and wide, and I've seen many a sore sight for sore sighted eyes. I have, you know, look at all these people.
All right, I believe you. I believe you. But you do know it's also okay not to have to be happy all the time. Always make feel the need to make others feel happy. Why? Some people are even happy being unhappy.
And why, pray tell, shall I listen to you anyway? One who seems so cynical about life and not prepared to see what else is out there, or even try.
That may be so. Well, I admit I'm not the same as you. And I don't go out of my way to make contact with others as you appear to do. Although I do admire your bravery for doing so. But that just isn't me. Perhaps it was at one time, long ago, but not now. I now know what people are really like.
So do pray tell, oh noble sir.
Look, I just come here on my own. I keep myself to myself. I trouble no one, no one troubles me. I have a drink or two and go back home, do all over again.
And where do you go back to?
Yeah.
Home and troubled one.
Oh, as I say, home.
But who do you have at home?
I have a wife and family.
And do you speak to them?
Not really.
And why not, pray tell?
Well, they just don't understand, all right.
And what don't they understand? That you're an emotionally bottled up old git?
You what?
I mean, oldish, gittish, kind sir.
Right, let me tell you something. I just sit here every evening, drink the drink to stop me sobering, to make everything more numb, thinking of the life I'm not leading, the thankless job I'm just not holding. My distant wife and family not knowing. The darkness that's been growing, from thoughts and feelings not flowing. My place in life no longer showing, replaced by those far better meaning. Friends no longer out of sound, things no longer interest me to see. I'm living my life in this isolation, devoid of the warmth of humanity. Going through the motions, marking time, until something else comes round, or I'll... I just sit here, every evening, drink the drink to stop me sobering, to make everything more numbing. Thinking of the life I'm not leading, the thankless job I'm just not holding. My distant wife and family not knowing, the darkness that's been growing, from thoughts and feelings not flowing, my place in life no longer showing. I was once in demand, always keen to lend a helping hand. People needed my skills, now they just pop their pills or search online for whatever Alexia they can find. Keeping up with the trend instead of staying on the mend. I just sit here, every evening, drink the drink to stop me sober, to make everything more numbing. Thinking of the life I'm not leading. Without this job, I'm just not holding. My distant wife and family not knowing. The darkness that's been growing. And thoughts and feelings not flowing. My place in life no longer showing. were placed on those far better needed. I just sit here and read.
I see, sir.
Oh my God.
How the life you've had can make a good man bad. But don't you see, in our differing ways, we're in actual fact the same.
No, I don't see you, sir.
Look, there is no C between you and me. Can't you see that?
A, no C, huh?
How can I put it? We are both lonely boats, all adrift upon the sea of life.
Lonely? Sea? Me? Huh?
See, amigo! Don't you see? We're the same, but exact opposites.
No, I still don't see you, C. Can we just please drop this sea thing?
Ah, I see what you're doing there. A drop in the sea. And yes, we both are.
What?
A drop in the sea.
No, I didn't mean like that. Can we please just drop this sea, sea and sea analogy?
Oh, poet as well as a philosopher. It's as easy as A, B...
Holy Saint Francis of Assisi! Can we now finally have a long time no see?
Okay, all right. Calm down. But don't you see? We're the same, but polar opposites, whilst both experiencing the same end result. Loneliness and not belonging. It's yin and yang, my good man. I am the hopeless eternal optimist, whilst you're a starboard blind pessimist. Your glass is forever half empty, whilst mine is always half full and very colourful as well.
Well, that may be so, but the difference is I don't need anybody, you do.
Ah, you like to think you don't, sir, but yes you do. We all do. It's just some circumstances you've pushed people away and become, as we say, isolated.
Well, if I have, that's my business and none of your business.
Again, dear friend, if I may be so bold, this is all because your role in life has changed, to be replaced, and you no longer feel like you have a role in society. You feel humiliated and, just not
so what are you saying then?
Well, there is, if I may be so bold once more to say, there is a malady for this, this word. When men feel they no longer have a role in life, becoming depressed with feelings of rejection and humiliation, it's called... it's called emasculation.
What? You called me a wanker?
No, fine sir.
So what did you say then?
I said emasculation, not...
Oh yeah, right. So what are you exactly meaning then, my laddie?
Well, the literal meaning of emasculation is, well, how shall I put it? The removal of the male sex organs.
You what? You question my funky manly virility now, are you?
No, thrice no, fine sir.
So what are you actually saying then? Tell me exactly, very slowly.
Okay. Emasculation is now used in common parlance to mean that due to a change of circumstances, beyond one's control that is, a male can be rendered to feel, well, less of a man.
Less of a man? Oh, less of a man? You're asking to lose your fucking manhood, if not already done so.
No, no, fine sir. I'm merely trying to say that due to a change of circumstances and the traditional roles all going all a bit wrong, men no longer feel like the governor of the manor. That's all I'm trying to say.
Right, let me show you who the governor of this here manor is then. Get rid of that thing and put that drink on the floor. Come on. We'll settle this thing once and for all. The old school way, by having a manly, pub-style arm wrestle. I'll show you what it's like to feel a real man and bring out the man in you. Okay. Kiss your hand. No, not like that. Proper man. Come here. Right. The first to force the other's back of the hand onto the top of the table wins, okay?
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
After three then. Yeah. Ready?
Yep, yeah, must.
One, two, three. Kiss your own dickhead. Watch that tree. Okay. After three again. Ready?
Uh-huh.
One, two, three.
I need a manicure as soon as possible. Yeah, okay. Tomorrow? Oh, you're a real life saver. You're in emergency service as well. That's crazy. All right, see you later. Ta-ta!
Oh, you've caught me on an off day, that's all. Touch your man flu. I've also had a very hard day at work as well. And not you, I presume.
That's as may be. Now see, sir, you're not as young as you once were, and things just don't stay the same. I've got a song for this one, so. For the times they are a-changing.
Possibly. I mean, I think I understand what you're getting about that. But what about you then? Because has your traditional role been replaced or changed? Because you could be perceived as being a bit effeminate, if you don't mind me saying so.
Well, I was never going to be a hod carrier, if that's what you're saying, sir.
Yeah, I can see that.
But I'm every bit of a man as the next man and should have the right to be myself, in whatever form that may take, and not be judged disapprovingly or thought of as being, well, less than a man for doing so.
Right you are. I'm off for a piss. Broken the bleeding seal again, ain't I?
Oh, why, sir? It does sound like you need your prostate prodding posteriously.
What? What are you offering?
No. I mean by professional, that is.
Well, no one's going to manhandle my bare behind, I can assure you of that.
Look, it doesn't take a minute, and it's such a relief.
And I really need to relieve myself now.
Oh. Stubborn male pride. What are we ever going to learn, eh?
Ladies and gentlemen, what the bleeding hell is that? What on earth is going on over there?
I think we might have a leak in the roof.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my little pub. My name's Jim. I'm the governor of this here boozer. And I'm very glad to see you all these times.
You all right, darling?
Yeah, good to hear. You all right, sir? Now, ladies and gentlemen, I hope these two characters haven't been disrupting your evening too much. They've been here for new on 3/4 an hour. They haven't even bought a packet of crisps. Gentlemen, good evening. Could I interest you in replenishing your drinks? After having ignored them for so long, that is.
No, we're fine, aren't we? Thank you very much. We each have at least half left. Why, is there something wrong with a beer we should know about?
Oh, no. There's nothing wrong with a beer here, as you well know. Now, I just thought you might like to put some life back in your glasses after being so engrossed in your conversation for so long.
Why, thank you, kind sir. Will you indeed replenish our drinks before the night is out? I can assure you of that. You have my honour and my bond.
Very well, gentlemen. But Well, I couldn't help overhearing what your conversation was about. If you ask me, that's, well, that's decent, blokes. Well, we're getting a bit of a bad press at the present, and it's leading some of us to feel, I don't know, undervalued. In fact, here's something. You know those good people, the Samaritans? Well, they've recently brought out a little brochure about a more serious matter, but nevertheless pertaining to the sort of feelings you two gentlemen were talking about. And guess what? I just so happen to have a copy about my person, because I keep one behind the bar just in case I overhear a conversation like the one that you jump or having.
Oh really? How very timely. And what good Samaritan you indeed are.
Well, it's easy for you to say that, but it's particularly important for me following the rather sad and shocking loss of one of our most popular regulars last year.
Oh yeah, I did hear about Frank, and I am deeply sorry for his loss.
Well, I appreciate that. But you see, that's why it's so important to get these things early, isn't it? And put a stop to them before they happen. I mean, did you know? No, here's something. Did you know there's been an increase in suicides amongst men in their middle years from deprived areas who are, and get this, who are up to 10 times more at risk of suicide than those from your higher social classes living in your more affluent areas?
No, I didn't know, but I do now. Very interesting. And thank you for uplifting the mood of my evening.
Oh, I was just saying, that's all.
Well, it's hardly rocket science, is it? That underprivileged middle-aged men from poorer backgrounds are more likely to feel, well... Anyway, you see the fight last night?
No, pray not.
No, I don't suppose you did.
No, it was my cake decorating class, which had simply not missed for love nor money.
Yeah, that figures.
But I did take the liberty of recording said bout, and will be perusing the pugilistic pursuit upon my return. So don't spoil the end result, my good man, for it will be a terrifically tumultuous tear-up.
You what? Don't tell me you actually like boxing.
ABA champion, 3 years running, don't you know?
No, I didn't. Knockout. What weight were you then? Cruiser or a long way to the bus stop?
Well, I was the right lightweight.
Yeah, I can see that. And now?
Well, I've gotten a few pounds since then. I had to give it up because I was starting to lose a bit of the old razzle-dazzle, and it was starting to have a devastating effect upon my youthful debonair demeanour. But they used to call me. This is what they used to call me. You get the right stance. Troubadour the Terrible! Hung like a buffalo, leaves him squealing like a banshee!
give over. More like the glass jawed timid tickler, if anything at all.
Oh, look, you never believe me. Let me find this. I'll show you. Here we go. Look. You can clearly see it's me. Well, no. Oh, okay, the lighting's been bad. But it's me, your call, the last of my three champion-winning belts. I know the lighting's a bit bad, but it's not my best side, but you can clearly see it's me.
Stone the crows. You could knock me down with a feather.
Quite possibly.
Yeah, well, that's very interesting. Did you notice that? Very good use of avoidance tactics. Now, if you two can take this on the chin, because it says here that some of the personality traits of these people include brooding and having no positive thoughts about the future.
What?
As well as the need to be more perfect. As well as being self-critical.
What?
Well, it says here, other factors include your social disconnection, events such as relationship breakdowns, and then maybe the most important, the perceived need to be masculine, to be the breadwinner, provide for the family. And of course, the sense of shame and defeat a man feels when he isn't.
Anyway, that's the boxing. So what's your record?
Well, now you see, this of course, some of them to turn to the drink, don't they?
At least some more, I would say. Good for business as well, I imagine.
No. I mean, everything in moderation. And to seek help if it's required. However, it also says here that another factor is some middle-aged men struggle to come to terms with their major social changes. They have fewer supportive peer relationships, and they can become dependent on a female partner for emotional support. Well, if they've got one, that is. Because more often than not, they're going to be living on their own, aren't they?
Ah, so you're the lucky one, sir, for you indeed hath a wife.
Well, it also says here that men are generally more reluctant to talk about their emotions and experience more, well, you know, your mental health difficulties and problems and unhappiness as a result, whilst also facing potential increased economic pressures. Now you see, all of which can allow things to build up to a breaking point. Because you see, they just won't go and get any help. And if they do, they're going to get prescribed pharmaceutical drugs.
Well, thank you very much, Dr. Bleeding Martin.
Well, I was just saying.
Well, don't. I just came in here to enjoy a nice quiet pint, and then I'm interrupted by this total stranger, having apparently travelled so far and bleeding wide. And now you. There are plenty of other boozers I could go to, you know. Or at least there used to be.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I haven't come here to spoil your evening alone, but... Whoopsie, I'm going to fall off the back of the stage! Hello, I'm actually going to leave you. Probably by a more conventional route. But before I go, could I just mention this one more thing? Because it says here that, policymakers should take into account of men's beliefs, and especially, well, what it is to be a man. And to recognise that loneliness is a very significant cause of suicide. As well as the need to address the relationships between alcohol consumption, deprivation, masculinity.
Well, you should start serving less masculine fueled alcoholic drinks then. So why don't you make my next one a Harvey Wallflower then, Ducky?
Ooh, boom, boom, boom. Yes, very funny. And I think I've come to the end of my sell by. So gentlemen, I'm going to leave you now to take a bit of refreshment. And but before I go, could I just say one more thing? Because all these things are important. It says here that GPs should recognise the signs of distress in men, especially those from deprived areas. And they should have access to a whole range of support, and not just your medication.
What, like meditation, man?
Well said, good man. There is indeed evidence it does help improve one's mental well-being. On my travels, both far and wide, I've tried many a multitudinous form of alternative medicine, which have indeed helped ease my lost and troubled soul.
You what? You'd need more than an extra strength packet of onery is to cure your troubled souls after travelling so far and bleeding wide in those things.
Ah.
Yeah.
Look, come. Take off your boots to ground yourself with Mother Nature.
Oh.
reminds me of the finest Moroccan Marrakesh shisha.
Oh, more like the lingering effects of a minkingly musky madras.
Ah, madras, one of the jewels of India. That is where I first learnt of meditation's therapeutic wonders, leading me along the long and winding road towards enlightenment.
Yeah, more like the jewel of India bolty house along the old Kent Road, for which you no doubt took the bus again to lead you windingly there.
Look, come, take off your boots. Come on.
You don't want to smell mine as well, I can assure you of that.
Ah, look, smells are nothing more than nature's natural odours.
But this ain't natural.
On my travels, both far and wide, I've smelled many a sulfurous, sickening stench that simply cannot compare.
Yeah, as I say, this ain't natural.
Take them off.
All right, remember, you were warned. Multiple warnings.
Yeah, you did. The removal of that footwear should come with a severest government health warning that only the Environment Agency can issue.
One man's feet or another man's poison.
Can't you smell that? Okay. Let's see if we can overcome this through the higher powers of meditation.
I'd like to see you try.
Okay. Right, sit straight. Back straight. Feet on the floor to ground yourself for Mother Earth. Hands palm up on your knees, like so. Breathe in through your nose. Come on. Hold for 3 seconds. And then out through your mouth, exhaling all the negative energy. Come on! Not like that, sir. Try to relax. Try to relax and do so 2 more times. Okay. How do you feel now, sir?
Far out there.
Oh, but don't you feel anything?
Well, yeah, I suppose I do feel slightly more at ease, yeah.
There you go. I just need to teach you the finer points of the lotus position, and you'll begin riding upon a higher plane of enlightenment before you know it.
You what? That's none of that pervy Kama Sutra stuff, is it?
Well, no, not exactly. But it does create the correct positionings for karmatic rumblings to develop.
Well, I think I'll pass on that for now, thank you very much. There's been enough mick been developing here for not one night as it is.
Well, John, I think I'm going to leave you now to your thoughts and your smells. As I've got other drinks to serve elsewhere. And especially seeing as you're still in denial of yours.
Well, if I could get more than a minute's bleeding peace.
Coming here. Some to make some noise, while others just stare in their beer. Well, I see it as part of my role, just simply offer an ear. If someone appears unhappy, let them be. Or to offer direction. If they just don't have a clue what to do. Either way, you know, it couldn't be more clear. When all said and done, it's a human condition to want to be free. be. So I offer a place of trust, respect, safety, for them to talk about their woes, to live and laugh and tell jokes about life. Yeah, no doubt a few about any long-suffering other asked. But you know, in amongst the warmth of this human zoo, bleary eyes after having had a few, and with a song in their heart and words in their rhyme, to go off until the need returns to come back and do it all again.
Classics type. Oh, young man, for you, the Graduates. No, Gone with the Wind. Wuthering Heights. No. You, Apocalypse Now, maybe? Yeah, it's on the waterfront.
Yeah, I could have been a contender. I could have been somebody instead of a amateur.
Do you want it with or without head?
Oh, with, of course, first mate.
Oh, it's not like that, you filthy young pup. It's two for a fiver with people's heads at the bottom of the screen. It's a pirate, you think. Or, straight Lady Godiva if you'd like one from our deluxe
room. Oh, Lady Godiva. Oh, that sounds really good. I have a straight bareback deluxe edition ride with her then.
Oh, which one do you want then?
Oi, 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 oi. What are you doing here? Come on, out. I told you before, you're not supposed to be here, but come on, out. You're going to get me in trouble with breaking standards, you are.
Yeah. Governor. I'm trying to make an honest living. Yeah, I've got three little ones to feed. He's only gone and put the bloody rent up again. He bloody wants me out as it is. Thinks it's bloody International Men's Day every bloody day of the week. Wants to gentrify the damn shoebox.
Oh, darling, that's not my problem, I'm sorry. I'm just a governor of this here, Bruce. So come on, off on your way.
Yeah,
out of here, off you go, off you go. Just one thing before you go. Didn't manage to get that French Sentley's art out of.
Next week, Governor. I'm working for the man who wants to keep me as I am. Working day and night, because he says, I'll see you right. I'm
Anyway, finally, getting back to what we were talking about, where were we?
Ah, well, I remember. Well, I was trying to convince you that in actual fact we were the same. Ironically speaking, that is, that we're both experiencing the same end result. Loneliness, not belonging, the not fulfilling of what it is to be a man.
Oh yeah, I remember. And that's possibly true, at least for you anyway. So what do you suggest we do about it?
Well, we can learn from each other.
Learn from each other? How do you mean?
Well, I could teach you how to get more out of life, sir.
What? Further than the route of the 53 bus, you mean?
No, yes. I could teach you how to step out of your comfort zone, to regain your faith in human nature, meet new people, discover your very well hidden talents.
And what about you then?
Well, you could teach me the more delicate realities of life, sir. You could open my eyes so I can distinguish between good and bad, right and wrong.
You mean who's taken the piss out of you and who isn't?
Right, you are, kind sir. Yes, but more importantly, which fair maids wish to run their long hands over my fine, upstanding male body? If only I could convince them to. Ooh, 'cause my world is nothing without a woman or a girl. Yeah.
Woo. So essentially, you're saying we both need to grow a pair then and grab life by the horn.
Right, you are, kind sir. Yes, you are learning, indeed.
You mean me to get in touch with my emotional side, and you to stop being such a vulnerable, naive fool, kind sir.
Yes, right you are again, kind sir.
I'll drink to that then.
Oh, yes.
Excuse me, gentlemen, did I hear you mention the word drink? Can I, at last, get you to put some life back in your glasses?
Why, yes, fine, sir. And how are you this fine evening, anyway? Forgive my rudeness for not having inquired earlier. And do pass on my sincerest to your nearest and very dearest.
You all right? Well, thank you. I will. But getting back to more immediate matters, what can I finally get you to drink?
Ah, yes. Why, I shall partake in the wetting of my wilting whistle and top up me tankard with half of whatever good fine beverages good fellow here has been quaffing. If you would indeed be so kind, that is, sir.
That's no problem. And you, sir?
Give us a half of his usual.
In the same glass?
Yeah. Just a complete cycle. Fill it up to the top, mind. I don't want any under measuring. If you would be so kind, that's good, sir.
Right, you are. Coming right up.
Why, my good man, I feel a song coming on.
Oh, my thoughts exactly.
Shall we?
Yeah! Come on, then.
Yeah.